Hi, Kansas City, and anyone else watching. You're watching a new episode of KCDIYYODA. It's a very peaceful and soothing and calm episode. The theme is quiet, and we hope you enjoy what you're going to see and hear today. First up, we have Kenzie interviewing Kelsey Wroten about her illustration. Enjoy.
Okay, it's very spooky down here in the studio. Welcome to this episode of KCDIYYODA.
Of whose line is it anyway?
Quiet. It's the episode title. I'm not telling you to be quiet. Okay. Right? It's quiet.
Okay, sorry.
That's whose line it is anyways. Hello, everyone. Here I am with Kelsey Wroten, one of Kansas City's fine illustrators, for this very spooky episode of KCDIYYODA. I'm going to try not to burn my hair. So, I don't know, let's get started with, like, what do you use to create your art?
Well, over the years it's changed a lot, mostly with becoming an illustrator, because that's what I do for my job right now. Like, before, I would say I would work more with, like, inks on paper, things that would take, like, you know, 12 plus hours to do, like, one drawing. And over time, because of the demands of actually working as an illustrator, I had to start, like, figuring out, like, better or more efficient ways of working. So now, when I can, I do things on paper, and I've gotten into painting recently, too, with gouache. But most of the time, I end up working digitally these days.
What is gouache?
Gouache is opaque watercolor. And the specific kind that I use is actually a mixture of acrylic and gouache called acrylic gouache.
That sounds awesome.
So it dries faster than typical gouache does, but isn't as shiny as acrylic.
Cool. So where can we see the progress on this? Are you, like, posting these on social media of your new experimenting?
Yeah, I do use Instagram like crazy. I think that, which it's at Jukebox Comics with an X, if you're wanting to follow
Maybe
me.
We can put it under here.
I don't know. Anyway, but I really think that that is the place where I post most of my process work, which I think that nowadays, if you're working as an artist and you have an Instagram, like, most people are following you to see how you do what you do. Because I feel like in the past it used to be more of like this Wizard of Oz, like, what goes on behind the curtain, because people, I think, were afraid to show their process because they're afraid that someone would come and bite their style. But now we know that's not true, and really it's just encouraging other people in your community to create.
Right. And so, isn't it like, you know, like, things aren't really stolen, like, you just kind of, like, you take it and roll with it and do your own spin on it.
Yeah, it's like evolving, it's pushing things forward, you know, that's what I think, at least. Some people still get really, like weird about their processes, but usually you're just like, you don't know what's wrong with them. They're just like really secretive, and it's kind of sketchy now to be secretive about your process.
What are you doing? Internet. Everyone's watching.
Stock photos? Like, what are you doing?
Yeah.
Privacy is sketchy now.
Yeah. Everyone can see everything. So why not?
Yeah.
Share the love. Do you have things to, like, show us today?
Yeah. I've brought some stuff. I brought actually a lot of stuff that is kind of in between my finishes, that I, you know, would post to my portfolio or something, just to kind of show that process, that in between work that I think is so, like, important and cool to share. So
Where can we find your things next? What are you working on right now? Anything super exciting, special that you're loving?
Yeah, I just finished up a short for Adventure Time, actually, that's going to come out in December. And I'm working on a graphic novel right now in my spare time, which is slated to come out through Uncivilized Books next November. So yeah, that's my big thing. It's still like an untitled project just because I haven't picked a title.
Right.
But I don't know.
Yeah, you gotta go like put them on a board.
It'll probably be the last
throw
thing
the
I
darts
do.
At it. Yeah.
I'll be like, whichever one makes people say like, what is that? It sounds gross. Like,
right.
Then
ooh,
probably.
Smell stain. Is something I was thinking of the other day.
Yeah. Like there's this really great comic called Stink Helmet that I really like, cool. But unfortunately I can't use that name.
Smell stain, I think it's.
Smell stain.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What is it? What is that?
Don't you want to read like 200 pages about smell stain?
Right. I'm interested.
Yeah.
So yeah, we can catch you on your Instagram. Do you do Snapchat too with your art, or is it just like?
No, I don't use Snapchat, but I do the Instagram stories and stuff with pictures of my cat. So
cool. Yeah, Instagram is great.
Yeah.
I'll see you there.
Cool.
Signing off.
Very informative, Kins. I appreciate it. A lot of great art. Speaking of art, up next we have an interview and a demo of art from Neon Nicodemus. Hello. Today I'm sitting down with Neon Nicodemus, and we're going to talk about art. Neon.
Yes?
Define art.
Well, I think if it doesn't have the potential of being a disaster, then it's not art. I can tell you more about what art isn't than what it is.
I see. Define your art, Neon's art.
It's a bit of a visual language, I suppose. They say a picture is worth 1,000 words. But my shapes and my colors, hopefully, are at least a paragraph. You know.
I see. A well-spun paragraph, I hope.
No doubt.
Then why did you start in the arts, and when?
I've been, you know, an artistic type person since I was a kid. Grew up being a skateboarder, grabbing cans of spray paint, writing on walls. And so I realized that this was my calling.
What inspires you?
The passion, man.
Obviously skateboarding.
For sure, right? Passion, yeah.
Yeah.
It's a way of investigating. Just like how you jump on your skateboard, roll down the street, see what's going on. You know the little cracks on the sidewalk. You know every little nook and cranny. Mm-hmm. I want to do the same thing, but on a surface. And that's what leads to the dangers, because you could hit a pebble and fall, you know? You never know what's around the corner.
How long does it take you to develop each piece? Do you have a general timeline, or is it just...
I tend to take too much time, if there is such a thing.
Yeah.
I like to, you know, ride that fine line of overworking something. Mm. Some people say that, oh, you should stop, it's done. I say, nah, man, keep going. Because that's, okay, once again, is the danger of ruining it. Artwork can be fragile sometimes. Yeah, there can be a certain brevity. You don't have to, once again, have 1,000 words. You can do a whole piece, and maybe it's just a sentence.
Right. I look forward to seeing your work, Neon.
No doubt.
Very good, thank you.
Cheers. Alrighty, folks. These cans of spray paint were passed down by my forefathers. There's many pieces of artwork made by these. It's important to give a little shake, rattle, and roll. Make sure you got your proper safety gear. This is what you call the underpainting. You want to get in there and really just let loose. I like to do the wet on wet technique. There's no such thing as a mistake. Happy mistakes. Make sure you have your proper cap. Get loose. Like playing a fiddle. I have some ancient artifacts that I like to use. Get some different textures, different shapes. I've got the main spaces and shapes blocked in. We've got some cosmic slop going down. It's magic. I like to use the end of my spray paint can as a brush. We got tools. I pity the fool. Going shame on a game. Sometimes you gotta clean the brush off a little bit. You don't really know what you're doing until you're doing it. Have fun, kids. It's for the children. This is what I like to call sunset orange. It's fluorescent, glows in the dark. Get your black lights out, kids. It's about to get psychedelic. Now right here, you got this little negative space. You take negative, turn it into a positive. Now don't forget your ancient artifacts here. This is the residue from something God knows. The devil may know. Yes. Now everything you do is going to turn into a face. You gotta fight that. That's what we like to call
biomorphic. Everything is of and relating to the human form. But it's morphing into something maybe more geometric, something pixelated. Who knows?
I'm so fucking high right now.
That's when you know you're doing it right. We're getting pretty close. We're getting pretty close here, folks. I'm gonna sign this. I'm gonna hide my signature because I hate it. You love it. You gotta have it. Enjoy.
Awesome.
You all enjoyed what Neon Nicodemus had to show us today. His art is beautiful. Art is beautiful. Now, let's see what Shy Boys has to say.
Hello. Welcome back, KCDIYYODA fans. Hope you're enjoying this quiet episode. I hope it's peaceful and relaxing for you. And in studio, we have Shy Boys, a beautiful, peaceful band that has many bubbling expressions and joys and melancholies and the like to share with you. So if we could just get a roll call here of your names, starting from the far left.
I'm Kyle Little.
I'm Kyle Roush.
Connor Irvin.
Colin Roush.
So why did you go with the name Shy Boys? Are you shy sometimes? Do you get anxiety? I'm sure you've heard this question a million times before.
And what's funny is that we were talking about what questions we might get asked, and that was the first one that popped up.
Oh, yeah.
I think Coney.
No, it was Tootie.
Tootie?
Well, actually, yeah, the band was called the Imes, and I suggested that we change the name, and then we both... separately, I came up with High Boys, and he was like, Shy Boys, and I was like, damn it, Shy Boys is better.
It's pretty perfect, and it kind of actually, it fits y'all's aesthetic pretty well. As far as just, it's very tender. It has a very tender and heartfelt feel to it, which is very cute. And, yeah, I like it. What's the most bashful experience you've ever had? And whoever has the first one has the best one.
That's probably a long laundry list for pretty much all of us.
Is there a good combined bashful experience you've had together?
Where we were all humiliated
at the same
one.
Time, yeah. as one bashful unit of boys, one a bastion of bashful boys. Why did I do that? A battalion.
I can't think of anything, and it happens all the time.
Yeah, I think, like, when we stayed at the quarry, and we were going to go have a dip in the lake, and we all round the corner, and there's this lady laying out in the nude on the deck, on the dock of the lake, and it really kind of caught us off guard, not expecting that.
Yeah, that is...
I immediately turned around and walked the other direction.
I thought we'd play it cool. Like,
I didn't. I peaced out real quick. I couldn't handle it.
Until they were like, yeah, everybody swims nude here. And we're like,
nope. I definitely couldn't do it. I have public nudity issues. Not other people being nude, but definitely myself. It's a rough go. It's a really rough. I should not have clapped. It's a really rough go.
<It's fine. laughs>
So do you have any like upcoming releases or anything that you want to talk about? Anything you're excited about coming up for Shy Boys?
Well, we have most of the record written at this point. The follow up. We're gonna take the rest of the year off to really nail those down.
Nice.
Moving forward so we can get this second one out.
Cool.
Been a long time coming.
Oh yeah. I mean I've been waiting. I'm very excited. Do you have any like music videos or anything planned? I've loved y'all's music videos so far. Really good. The one that you guys did with Christopher Good, I think, right? Mm-hmm. That one was
both of them Chris did for us.
Yeah.
Actually.
Cool.
Yeah, it was great.
Oh, yeah.
He hit me up and he's like, yeah, I got this idea. And I was like, do we have to be in it? And he's like, no. And I was like, great. and then we did one for that for Life is Peachy.
Yeah.
Which is really cool.
Which you did make a guest appearance in.
Yeah.
Where can we find some of your sultry, soft, and peaceful tunes at?
Well, we're on iTunes.
iDiveRecords.com.
We have records and tapes cool. And Spotify.
All the normal places.
Are you on Pandora? Do you have a...
Probably,
I think so.
Yeah.
Okay.
We have CDs.
There's cool. A Bandcamp too, right?
Amazon.
Shyboys.bandcamp.com.
Apple Music.
Yes, is that
one.
Okay. I'm just going to just... flitter across the bottom of the screen. All right. Well, I'm excited to hear you all play. I think this is going to be a great set, and I'm very, very excited for these peaceful, easy feelings. All right.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks for tuning into this week's episode of KCDIYYODA. Quiet. Tune in next week.